You had this idea of giving refugees a camera so they can could film it themselves.
Yeah.
It seems like an obvious idea. Was it that easy as it sounds?
Well, if you want to make this film, a huge part of it is in order to see what it's like through the eyes of refugees, you have to go to the places that they go to, and I can go to a certain, you know, I can go to Africa, I can go to Agadez, I can go to the Turkish border of Syria. What I can't do is when they go into when they sort of hand over their trust into the world of smugglers, it's very difficult for me to follow, mainly because I put their life in danger and I impede their process. And at that point, I hand over to them. If they want to film, and it's up to them, then they do that. And that's how we get that sort of privileged access to places that I could never go.
Why did you say yes to his question if you wanted to film on board of the dinghy?
I mean, to be honest, I've never planned it to I didn't know that the footage that I took will be part of the big series, like these excerpts in the documentary. But the first reason why I started documenting this was I had a family back in Syria and I left them. And I just wanted to show them that, look, if I die, if I lose my life while making the crossing, I have to always upload all the footage of the videos on cloud so a brother of mine can access them on the internet. So if I lose my life, my family could see the footage and they could see what I've done to help them and help myself get out of that situation.
Because what we can't feel, I mean, we can read the news, we can read the papers, we can see it, but what we can't feel is the fear you have before you get in. Because you say you even reckon with the fact that you could die getting in. How big a chance was it, in your opinion, when you got on that boat that you would survive?
This is the challenge which a lot of refugees, and especially Syrians at the moment, they are facing. Because if you look back, you've got shellings, you've got bombing, and you've got ISIS knives, you know. And if you look forward, you've got the sea. You don't have an option, you know. So it's just a bitter choice. So you're dead anyway. It's just a gamble. You just do it.
We got some footage of you guys on the boat. Het is best wel heftig om naar te kijken. Althans, dat vond ik. Ik zag de documentaire. Ik dacht van, wow, dat heb ik niet eerder op die manier gezien. En je wordt eigenlijk meegenomen in een deel van uw reis. Je zit op de bank thuis, dus dat is lang niet zo erg als de mensen die je hebt meegemaakt. Maar toch, een klein stuk daarvan in de boot. What we see happening here is that there's getting water into the boat. You've been on a boat like this as well.
Yes.
Could you describe the situation in the boat?
You know, this is one of the most difficult moments of your entire life when you see like half of the dinghy, women and children, you know, they're crying, they're bleeding, and you're helpless. You can't do anything. You know that you are dying. You're losing your life. It could be 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and you're dead. This is your last minutes in life, and you try everything to cling to life, but you feel helpless.
Does it change you after an experience like this?
It changes you for better. It changes you to fight more for these people, because it's something not going to go away. Today, across the globe, there are 65 million refugees. You know, they had to leave their home, 65 million people, yes, and every one of them has got a story. You know, I mean, why at the first place? Why would someone, for example, who was born in Syria, who's got family there, he's got his memories there, would leave it and put his life and everyone's life in danger if they don't have to, and they didn't have to?
Why did you have to leave?
It was a very difficult decision to make, to be honest. I mean, at the first place, I never wanted to leave my country. I had a very good job. I was a student there. But once you get to the decision, when you feel like you don't have an option, either to be killed by your own government or be involved in killing of people, then you choose, the other way around. No, I want to keep away from all this bloodshed. I don't have to get involved in this.